Ya empezamos la entrevista.
Ay, está muy bien.
Por favor, ¿qué es su nombre?
¿Qué es mi nombre? ¿Cómo te llamas?
Para los quien va a ver.
Me llamo Alma. Alma María del Pilar Macusé Muñoz. El nombre me lo escogió mi papá cuando tenía 8 años de edad. Él, yo, porque vino una muchacha a Morelia, una muchacha francesa que se llamaba Alma de Guetón. Él se enamoró de ella y dijo, cuando tenga una hija le voy a poner Alma.
No me digas, yo nunca sabía eso.
Y lo cumplió 20 años después, cuando nací yo.
Eres la primera hija de sus papás.
Soy la primera hija de los 9 hijos que tuvieron mis papás.
Ok. ¿Y has vivido...? Bueno, ¿naciste en dónde?
Nací en El Oro, México, un mineral en el Estado de México, donde se conocieron ahí mi papá por la revolución. Salió mi abuelo de Morelia a El Oro a hacerse cargo de la maquinaria. Él era ingeniero de la maquinaria donde se molía el oro. Fue a trabajar, mi papá también trabajaba en la oficina, en la contabilidad.
Okay.
Y allí se...
¿En la mina?
En la mina.
¿Pero cómo se llamaba?
La mina se llamaba Tiro México.
Ok, espérense un segundo. All right. This is Alma, the daughter, the eldest daughter.
No, the oldest daughter. I'm the second oldest.
Okay.
Of my parents.
And she's here to translate and add comments.
Fernando Ibarrola Arriaga.
Can you sum up?
My mother was born in Tiro México, in El Oro. It's a small town, mining town near the mine where her father was an accountant. Tiro México. A lot of people left places during the revolution. Morelia, they left Morelia and went to, my great-grandfather went to there to take care of the equipment.
And when was the revolution?
The revolution 1910. Empezó en 1910. Started in 1910. It went on forever, but started around 1910.
En 14, mi abuelo estaba en Uruapan, con una fábrica de hilados y tejidos que trajo de Francia.
1914, he was in charge of my great-grandfather had here in Morelia originally hilados y tejidos, looms.
Looms for weaving?
Fabric, yes, weaving looms in the calzada. And the governor lived next door and he found it too noisy. So they had to move. And then they sold the equipment to this place in Uruapan. And they bought it on the condition that he went there and showed them how to use it. The equipment was French. And then afterwards, during the revolution, they went to Mexico. He was an engineer by profession. And he went to take care of the equipment that ground the gold.
That what?
Ground the gold.
Ground
from
the gold.
The mine. Yes.
So. All right, and your mother said she's one of 9 children?
She's the oldest of 9 children.
And who are her, can you list off her siblings?
Okay, first is Alma Ochaca.
This is Alma
Cristina Kitty.
Also known as Kitty.
Lourdes, Mimi. Then Jaime. Then Agustin.
Kitty.
Then,
Pitín.
Ricardo.
Eso no, alguna cosa de una novela francesa con mi tía Marta fue la que le puso Pitín.
Then, Ricardo, and Ana, and then Julie.
Ana María.
Ana María, ¿qué me faltó?
Rosa.
Ay, sí, sorry, I miss. Tía Rosita. Tía Rosita comes before tío Ricardo. After tío Agustín.
Es antes que Ricardo.
Por eso, before tío Ricardo, after tío Agustín. So that's 9.
Wait, Julie?
Julie is the youngest. I did say.
Okay, all right.
Ana María y Julieta.
Those are the two youngest.
Ana María is tía nena.
Right. Everybody in Mexico calls her tía nena or la nena.
La nena.
And nena is her nickname since childhood?
Yes. Nena means baby. The baby. So when she was little, they start calling her the baby, and then she became the baby forever and ever. Sometimes women call Elena, are called Nena, but that's a different
right
context. But okay, for her, it was the baby.
Okay. Well, we're sitting in the Hotel Virrey de Mendoza. Okay. I'm going to ask Jata to explain just brevemente, in dos minutos, la historia de esta. Este hotel no estamos ahorita.
Bueno, este hotel, 75 años antes o 90, lo compró a esta finca, estaba ya destruida, derruida, era de un canónigo de la catedral moreliana.
Right, espérate. Let's translate it piecemeal. So you translate
okay,
what you just said.
Okay, this house was in rather poor repair. She says about 75, 90 years ago, but I think it's a little more than that.
Okay.
Okay, John.
Maybe 90, yeah.
All right. We have to pause because something very important has arrived.
Yes.
And we have to deal with this.
Los chilaquiles son allá.
Oh, yeah, I have chilaquiles. This is...
Ese es un solo huevos para la señora. No, yo chilaquiles.
Chilaquiles?
Solo huevo, y ese es para...
This is chilaquiles, okay. All right, and chilaquiles with my bacon. Very good. All right, we're gonna pause the camera now.